put that one on this value, you can easily see that when we put this quantizer output on this term, we have here. Okay, so basically what is now the prediction filter, it is the output of this quantized error signal, the whole of this first term and then the second term, plus the predicted signal X prime NTS. Okay, but then again, this error, this prediction error ENTS, is now equivalent to XNTS as shown here, plus X prime NTS. Okay, subtract that one as depicted in this equation. Okay, and then transposing this one on the other side of the equation to solve for the XNTS, which is the sampled input. Okay. Okay, continue transposing that one on the left side of the equation. Also, this one we have here now the input signal. Okay, now to solve finally for the prediction filter, this one, the prediction filter input, we need to add the input signal as shown here. Okay, and then the QNTS, which is the output at the quantizer. Okay, so that's it. Now, as you can see here, XQNTS. So we just represent this one. We substitute from this XQNTS. ENTS is here. X prime NTS is here. So substituting that one on this equation plus the quantizer, we have here the prediction filter. Okay. So basically, our goal in this equation is actually to compute what is the prediction filter input. For a short simulation, with respect to the DPCM transmitter working principles, let's take for example our sample signal is 1.1. Okay, so let's take for example our sample signal is somehow below at this second point. Okay, and the sample signal. Sample signal is represented by XNTS. Okay, at this point it is 1.1. Okay, going to this summer circuit or comparator circuit, since we have plus and minus circuit here, plus and minus. For example, our prediction filter, our predicted value is zero. Okay, the predicted value of DPCM transmitter is zero. Okay, so add and then subtract. Okay, we have here 1.1 and then zero X prime NTS. Okay, so from that, based, as we have said, the main principle is subtraction, diba? Subtracting the sampled signal. We have subtracted our sampled input with respect to the prediction. So 1.1, 0, subtract that one, it's equivalent to 1.1. Okay? And then we move that one on the quantizer. The quantizer now sets a certain value that is in a standard form. Okay? Meaning, when we have a 1.1 value, it standardizes it into 1. Another case is that when we have a value of 0, 0.2 specifically, it is standard that on 0. Okay, for example, 2.5, it's standard that depending on their configuration, okay, it would standard that's either on 3 or on 2. Okay. If that's the case. And for example, 3.2, right? It will standardize that one on 3, right? That's the main point under quantization. Okay, so given that fact, so subtract, error here, and then quantize goes to a quantizer. The standard value for 1.1 is 1. And then, as we have said here, now to produce XQ, NTS or the prediction filter input. Okay, so we need to add this one, 1, and then this output of the prediction filter, which is the predicted value, which is 0. Okay, so that will become 0 plus 1 equivalent to 1. Okay, another one, for example, although it is not stated on this black diagram, is 1.2. Okay, 1.2, the prediction of our DPCM is, instead of 1.2, it predicts 1. Okay? From that prediction, it subtract 1.2 minus 1 is 0.2. The principle of DPCM, the definition itself. Okay? And then produce the quantizer. So the standard value, if we run down it, the quantizer is 0. As you will notice, if there is a spike, okay, it will produce a staircase pattern instead of just this one. Okay, so standard value of quantizer 0. Now you will be to produce this prediction filter, as you can see here, we would actually add 0 and then 1. Okay, so from that, the prediction filter, now as you can notice here, that will be our next, okay, that will be our next prediction. From this point, it will now be our next prediction on our next sample data. Okay. So, going rundown on this one is actually the predicted value based on our past values. So, 1, proceed that one, subtract, concept of differential PCM. So, 0.3, this will move to the quantizer, so that the standard value of 0.3 is still 0. Then add the output and then the quantized error, 1 plus 0. Okay, and then we will try to encode that one. Okay, so encoding that one will produce the following, this one. Okay, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, as shown here. Okay. So all of these bits, EQ, NTS, this one, EQ, NTS is actually up until this one. Okay, this one. So for example, our encoder is a 10-bit encoder, for example, we will produce that one, it will go to the encoder and then will produce the following transmitted bits. Okay, so the transmitted bits will now be 0, 0, 1, and so on. Okay, so as you can notice, if we encode that one, for example, in 10-bit encoder, it will produce a binary digits of transmitted bits. So 1 is represented by 001, 0 is represented by 00 in binary, similarly to this one, and so on. Okay, that's it. Okay, so having learned the principle, working principle of DPCM, we are now ready to recover the data. Okay. So recovering that data, for example, let's just recover it on the last part, 001, for example, okay, this data, okay, later on, we will recover that one and then produce a certain output. But let me introduce first the DPCM receiver. So the DPCM receiver consists only of the predictor. No? So it doesn't have a quantizer compared to the DPCM transmitter. Of course, it has a decoder on it, okay? Comparing that one on the transmitter, which has an encoder. Okay, the input of the decoder is represented by B and TS, as shown on this block diagram. And then it will go back, it will go to the decoder with a certain error, okay? Decoder error for this one. So EQ and TS, that will sum up with the predictor on the decoder. Okay, X prime NTS, okay, we will go to the from that, when we have decoded that one, it will produce a quantized value already as shown on this figure, and then from that it will now produce the low pass filter, will turn our quantized value on a continuous wave CW, continuous wave signal, or our original signal, okay, from the input itself. Okay, so that's it. So how can we solve for this one? XQNTS. Okay, XQNTS is this input. So what's the equation for that? The equation for that is that the output of the predictor filter, X prime NTS plus the error, okay, from the decoder itself, the output of the decoder. So EQNTS would produce the XQNTS, okay, the quantized value of our signal itself. So, having said that, we try to have an example in similar way to the transmitter side. So, going back, for example, we try to predict this one. Okay, 001, as we have said, the last part of these bits. So, predicting that one, 001 on the receiver side, it will go to the decoder part. Okay, so the decoder part will now decode these three bits into only one bit, which is represented by this one. Okay, so depending on the decoder, later on we will dig in deeper with the different kinds of decoder. So, but our focus now is just the modulator working principles. Okay, so 001, it will now decode it as 1. And then based on our predictor output, that will become 0 initially. Okay, the original input is 1, the prediction of our DPCM is 0. However, it will correct that one later on as the as our encoding progresses. Initially, it will predict it as 0 instead of 1. Okay, what's the difference? It is 1. Okay, I'm sorry for that. What's the addition based on this summer circuit? 1 plus 0, that is in comparison to the comparator circuit on while back. Subtract, while back, in this case, we will be adding that one. Okay? So 1 plus 0 is 1, the output. Okay? And then that will be our staircase pattern. Next one is, for example, our input signal is 0 as represented by these bits. Okay? 1. 0 0 1 0 0, okay, zero, another bit decoding that one. Okay, based from our predictor, the output of our predictor is 1. Now will the output for this one will now be 1. Okay, so 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay, that is represented by this one again. Based on our circuit, that will become our next prediction value. Okay, 0 input predicted as 0, so 1 plus 0 equals 1. Okay, now XQNTS is actually here. Okay, this one. Okay, so 111. Okay, it will go to the low pass filter, now produce our continuous wave signal as shown, 11122. If we try to go over or continue this table, it will produce 2-2 as shown here. Okay. So basically that's for the differential PCM. So we have differentiated PCM, pulse code modulation, with DPCM, in a sense that we said that if pulse code modulation actually encodes directly the data with the input, with the sample data, in comparison to differential pulse code modulation. So differential pulse code modulation compares first the sampled with the predicted and then subtract that one. Okay, and then process that one to quantizer and then the encoder itself. Okay, and then we have differentiate in terms of the advantages and the disadvantages of them. Okay, with respect to PCM, PCM has have a disadvantage of a redundant bits on it. So since since PCM is highly correlated, they have a relation, the relationship between one variable is the same as the other variable. Okay, as other one increase, it increase or decrease, or other one decrease and so on. And from that correlation, it actually involves a certain error, which is the a certain error in the redundant bits. Meaning, for example, we have 3 bits have the same values. Okay, so that that redundant bits of 2 will now be eliminated using DPCM. So we have described also what is a differential PCM. So differential PCM is actually as a version, okay, a version of a pulse code modulation Okay, wherein, as we have said, sample the difference between two sampled value. Okay, that's it. We have discussed already the working principles of DPCM and then the DPCM transmitter and then receiver. Under DPCM transmitter, it is composed of the quantizer and then the prediction, the predictor filter, together with the summer circuit. Okay, specifically the comparator and then these other circuit. Then with respect to the receiver, it composed only of the predictor filter. Okay, and of course the with respect to the encoding and then the decoding aspects. Okay, we have also discussed about, we have the simulated sample bit for the transmitter so that we can understand the working principle of DPCM transmitter shown on the following tables. Okay, and then from this table, we have recovered the signal through a DPCM receiver as shown on the simulated bits as shown here on the figure, the presentation. Okay. Again, we have reiterated the advantages of DPCM, wherein we have a bandwidth requirement is less, okay? Quantization error is reduced, number of bits is actually reduced also. Okay, so that ends our presentation for today. Thank you and have a good day.